Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and thank you once again for tuning in. And if you have not already done so, please, where am I today? Well, I've decided this afternoon, because I had a couple of hours spare, to come to this place. I am at the Olympic Park in Beijing. First things first, this place is huge, because if I go this way, I'd be heading up north into the Olympic Forest, which goes on for miles. And if I go this way, is the way to the bird's nest passing the Olympic Tower. So I am going to go this way and I will share the Olympic Tower, bird's nest and a few other things with you. So please follow me as I get lost in this mammoth place, as I get lost in this huge place, the Olympic Park in Beijing. Join me. Well, you should know me by now, a trip out is not a trip out unless I'm eating ice cream. This is Chinese ice cream, because I couldn't find an old favourite like Walls or something. So this is a Chinese ice cream. And it's bloody good. So I was hoping to go up this big bad boy. Even though I'm scared of heights, it would have been fantastic to be able to say I've actually went up the Olympic Tower. But as you can see over there, at this moment in time, it's not actually open, so I'm not sure why. I'll maybe come walking back up this way and see if I can get to go up. It's fantastic when it's lit up at night, so it would have been fantastic to be able to say I went up the Olympic Tower in Beijing, but today doesn't look like that's the thing. This building here in the distance used to be the telecommunication place for the digital hub, if you like, for the Olympics when it was launched. And this here was a digital TV tower. This first one I showed you, this one here, is actually a science museum now, and it's pretty cool. It's a digital science museum. But yeah, well, keep walking and I'll show you more. I love the fact that as you walk through the park, there's actually music playing on the speakers. So I don't know if you can hear this, but there's music playing from these speakers here. And it just adds something nice, the whole experience of wandering around a massive park in the middle of a city with 22 million people. It's just incredible. And here you go, there's a big fella behind. So right behind me here is a shopping mall, as you can see, a little Costa coffee there. But it wasn't so late in the afternoon, I think I would have had a coffee, but not for me, not this late, I'll never get to sleep. However, the last time I was here, I took my two kids who were in Beijing to a duck restaurant in this shopping mall. The food, as always, was fantastic, but now I'm going to go and see the bird's nest. So here we have the indoor area. During the Olympics, this was used for the indoor Olympic events. And then the distance here, you can see in the blue cube, that's the indoor swimming area, which obviously used for the swimming events. Over here, we have the bird's nest, which, as you can see, is very close. So this whole area would have been full of people. And who can't forget the opening ceremony, which was just amazing. And it really put Beijing on the map. The opening ceremony was one of the best, I think, Olympic opening ceremonies we ever had. And I remember watching it on TV thinking, wow, who was expecting that? And if there is one building in the whole of Beijing that I absolutely hate, is this building here. Hate it. Why? For some strange reason, it always reminds me of Donald Trump. So there it is. That's the bird's nest. Show you some more photographs in a second. But I think it can hold now 88,000 people. For the Olympics, it held 91,000 people, and it's pretty massive inside. So yeah, that's a bird nest. The other interesting thing, which I didn't know until I was watching a video the other day, and that's why I came to the park, is that the park is situated on the Beijing Center axis, which is where the flow of the city runs right up through the middle of the middle of the city, if you like. And that takes in things like the South Gate, the Forbidden City, Tiananmen Square, or should I say Tiananmen Square, Forbidden City, the drum and the bell tower, and it goes straight all the way up into the Olympic Park. And I believe it continues all the way up into the forest. So that is the central axis for Beijing, which is a fact I did not know. And that's what brought me to the Olympic Park today, because I thought I want to go see that and explain that. But there's the aquatic center, the indoor swimming pool area, the aquatic center. So there you have it, more of Beijing. So that's me finished for today. I'm going to head back. It is a bit more cloudy now, but if I don't head back, I'll get caught in traffic and then it will take me a while to get back. I'll share some previous pictures of the bird's nest in the evening at night when it's lit up, because I've been here before, and I'll share that with you now. Meanwhile, please, as always, subscribe to my channel, and if you could, you like this video, then give me a big like, because that helps, apparently, helps the algorithm, and it'd be good for more people to see Beijing and China, to see what things are like here. And finally, there's one more thing that I would like to talk about, and that is concerts, live music. And the park is actually quite frequently holding live concerts. I've been to two live concerts here. One with a local artist from China, which was really interesting, and I'll share that video with you now. And then the second concert that I've been to here is an arena concert. Liam Gallagher of Oasis / Liam Gallagher fame. So I'll share these videos with you now. I hope you find them interesting. I might not be able to get the sound on it due to copyright issues, but with any luck, you'll get the point. Meanwhile, as always, thank you. Peace out.